the neighborhood small grant applicant?
Yes. Likely story, like anybody's going to believe.
I object.
Excuse me, but my client is right. We are gonna win.
Says who?
Says me.
Oh, you think you're right? Right? You don't think.
Quiet.
Party, and the first year the kids did the plan 5 minutes. The next year it took an hour. This year they're planning it weeks before. So I don't know what's gonna happen next year. We'll see. Anyway.
So. My goal was to teach people how to make Christmas-themed origami, but then it turned into just making a crane for some people that don't know how to make it, and then turning it into an ornament. So, yeah. There's actually not much to say about this.
That's so awesome! I did a 5-week stress management workshop, and I did non-denominational. They were like, each session was 40 minutes long. One of my best moments were just before the class started, people who didn't know each other before the session were all chatting with each other and having a great time.
To commemorate a very, very extraordinary artist in the Kitsilano community, Hannah-Lore Evans. And Hannah-Lore had passed away earlier in the year. And we had the opportunity through this grant to commemorate the life and the spirit of Hannah-Lore, who was a celebration artist.
A tribute and honor. To honor not only Hannah-Lore, not only the beginnings of celebration art, but also to honor history. The seed saving library, which is just over there, that big box, and I think.
Garden at 6th and U to my garden, so you'll hear about that.
That's so awesome.
Pleased to, a woman named Chloe Bennett, who's not related to me, started a Mason Bee castle at the traffic circle at 6th and 5. So I met up with her, I guess, through Village Vancouver. And my project's not complete, so you're all invited to the final part. But I had a couple of workshops where we made some Mason Bee houses from Chloe's garden at 6th and U to my garden. So you'll hear about that.
That's so awesome. Thank you so much. That's...
Hi, I'm Elizabeth, and the Bee Gate. So we started the honeybee hive at the community gardens at 7th and Maple, in between Cypress and Maple. And I saw an advertisement that said, oh, the small neighborhood grants, start a beehive. I was like, whoa, that's me. So the timing was perfect. And the bees, I saw them today. They came out. They're alive. They've survived their first winter. So hopefully the winter is mostly over. Charlotte, would you like to tell the bee joke?
What did the bee say to the flower?
What did the bee say?
Hello, honey.
For my group, we are the cooking and baking group, and so just that you get an idea of who we are, so we called it ESL Cooking and Baking Group because we're all from different countries, and from 6 different countries actually, like Sophie from China, Monica from Brazil, and Michelle from France, and Ben from Taiwan, and did I miss someone? No. And Natalie had to go, so she's from Venezuela. And of course. So I'm from Germany. So we have a little presentation here because we kind of thought that we need to show you some pictures because we cannot just talk about food. You have to see it. So
I decided to introduce a community element through the small grant because previously it's always been an event geared towards non-profits promoting themselves and also African vendors selling their things. So this year we decided to bring in a sort of family element, and the small grant enabled me to put on a community corner in the African market. So we had several sort stalls set up where we could show people how to do very innovative things with garbage, basically.